three daycare employees sign off saying they have checked the van. But hours later, a four-year-old girl is found still strapped in her seat.
It's like sitting inside a freezer for 5.5 hours.
The girl's father wants answers, and the daycare is ready to explain. Good evening. Little Lambs Daycare is no longer using that van and plans to change the way staff transport children.
This is the second time the daycare at 44th and Cumming has made major changes, and the second time it's been in trouble for leaving a child in a van.
On Tuesday, the daycare says 4-year-old Haley Maxson stayed in her seat for 6 hours because staff failed to check the van. Now Haley's parents want answers. I took their concerns to the daycare.
The person in charge that drove the van that she was left on said that she had checked the vehicle, even though she didn't.
James Maxson found out two other employees did the same thing Tuesday afternoon. At 3 o'clock, Little Lambs Daycare says a driver found his 4-year-old daughter, Haley, sitting in the van. Daycare owner Cheryl Godsey shows us how the system failed.
So here's the van driver's signature. A second person signs saying, "I checked the van." That's a signature. Then a director signs.
Three signatures that shouldn't have been there. Godsey runs both locations of Little Lambs Daycare and Preschool at 44th and Capitol and at 39th and Harney, where Haley Maxson and her brother went. In November of 2010, Nebraska Health and Human Services investigated a complaint about a 2-year-old left on a Little Lambs van for 5 hours. Dan Godsey, Cheryl's husband and then president of Little Lambs, was cited for misdemeanor child neglect and later resigned. As a result of that incident, the state ordered Little Lambs to change its transportation policy to include checklists. On Tuesday, when Godsey questioned the three employees, she got a response she never wanted to hear.
That sometimes we don't check vans after school runs, or, you know, it was... Yeah, they didn't have any explanation.
For the Maxsons, that's not the answer or the solution. They say they may seek legal action. Either way, Godsey says she and her staff are terribly sorry.
They're all very sad today. They've been sad. You know, because we actually left one of her little lambs behind.
The Maxsons say they're upset that they didn't get a call right at 3 o'clock when Haley was found. Little Lambs Daycare says because Haley was safe and okay, they wanted to tell the parents in person. Now, as for the three employees who signed the checklist, they lost their jobs, and Omaha police are investigating their actions.